And now we will learn how to set up your QuickBooks file to be able to record leases. If you have any questions about this topic, you can leave them in the comments section below and I'll do my best to help you. And of course, if you feel the video helped you, I hope you will click like and don't forget to subscribe to get updates on new videos that come out all the time. What is a lease? Well, a lease is a contract between the tenant and the landlord where the tenant agrees to stay and pay for a specific number of months at a specific monthly rate. This contract is satisfied over time as the tenant continues to stay and pay. What information do you need about a lease? Well, you need a report that shows the total balance of the lease compared to the amount that has actually been paid thus far. You need a report that shows the percent complete of the lease. And you need to see at any moment how many months remain on the lease. So how do you do that in QuickBooks? Well, all contracts that are satisfied over time are put into QuickBooks as estimates. You first make the estimate like you would make any other QuickBooks document and put in the lease information. Every month, you make an invoice against that estimate, and then QuickBooks will be able to give you the lease information with one click of a mouse. So what are the setup steps? Well, first, you have to make sure that progress invoicing and estimates are activated in the preferences window. So if you come back to QuickBooks here and you click Edit Preferences, you can see that one of the categories is jobs and estimates. And in the company preference tab, you have to make sure that do you create estimates is checked yes, and do you do progress invoicing, and that should also be checked as yes. Then you can make an estimate, and the estimate will give you the report of the progress of the lease. Click OK, and we'll move to the next step. Now, we will customize and put up the reports that show the progress and information about the lease. So, from the main menu, we click Reports. Now, the category of reports that relate to estimate is under Jobs, Time, and Mileage. These reports here that say Jobs Estimates versus Actual and Job Progress Invoices versus Estimate, these two are the most important ones. So let's put them up and let's actually customize them before we put them up, and we will customize them in the way that we learned in prior videos. So click Job Estimates versus Actual Detail. Now it gives you a choice of which particular tenant or building. Let's just leave Meadow Lane because we can filter this report later. Click OK, and now all we're going to do is click Customize and change the header. Instead of saying estimates versus actual, we'll put progress on lease. And this report will actually show the money amount. So we can put financial progress on leases, because this will be the report that shows the total money of the lease compared to the total that you have earned during the lease at any given moment. We can remove some of the irrelevant information just like we did in previous videos. And now we have financial progress on the lease as the title. We can even make this column a little wider, or you can do any kind of customization you want and then put it up. Once the report looks the way you need it to look, click View, add this report to the icon bar, and let's make the title in the window or the label in the icon bar the same as the title on the report. Financial progress on leases. Financial progress on leases. Click OK. And now it can open up from the icon bar exactly the way we set it up. The other report is this: reports, jobs, time and mileage, job progress, invoice versus estimate. Now for this one actually shows the percent complete. So we're going to click customize and click header footer, and we're going to put percent progress on leases. And now we have two reports that will give us what we need. We have one report that will show the percent complete and the percent remaining, and another report that will show the money amount that's complete and the money amount that's remaining. And these are the reports you would check during the life of the lease. And last but not least, make a customized lease document from an estimate template. And we learned in a previous video how to customize the documents. First, we have to open the document itself. From the main menu, click Customers, and then put Create Estimate. Now you can see in the top left, it already comes with four different templates for estimates, proposal, quote, and so on. But we want to make one that says lease. So as we learned in a previous video, we click Formatting, Manage Templates, and the Manage Templates window opens up. We also learned in a previous video that you have to choose the one that most closely approximates what you need and then click Copy. And what QuickBooks will do is it'll create a new one that's really a copy of the old, and you have to just change the name and call it Leases. And click OK, and we now come to the basic customization window. If you remember, the only thing we really need to change is the word in the top right here. We need to change that word from estimate to lease. And we can't do it in the basic window. We have to come down here and click Additional Customization. And all you have to do in the title bar, in the field that allows you to change the title, change the word estimate to lease. Now, while you're here, you can change anything else you want. You can explore and experiment with all the other changes. And if you really want to have total artistic control over the look and feel of your estimate, you can click this third window, Layout Designer, and then it will allow you to play around with it and change the position of text and boxes and so on. But we only need to click OK. And then click OK again. And notice we now have one template that says lease. We can choose another template that says quote or another word. But at least if we click here, we know we're putting in a lease.